Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to talking about anemia. This video is just a review. For further details you can check your recommended books. So let's start. First we have what is anemia. We know that it's basically reduction in the concentration of hemoglobin in the below normal limit for a particular age and a sex of an individual. So we can say that reduction in the concentration of hemoglobin is known as anemia. Now what are the typical values and WHO values of an anemic person or a normal person? The typical values for the males are 135 gram per liter, but in the female these are less and 115 gram per liter. Now what are the WHO values? Let's see. The WHO values in the males are 135 gram per liter, and in the females obviously these are less, that is 120 gram per liter. If you focus at 130, 135 or 120, from this you can easily remember. Now let's see what are the signs and symptoms of an anemic person. First we have fatigue, then tiredness, next we have murmurs, means speaking very quietly, next pallor, means paleness of a skin, next we have palpitations, it means irregular heartbeat, next we have the faintness, next mild pyrexia, means increased body temperature, next anorexia, means eating very little amount because of becoming of obese. Last but not the least, it's impaired bone healing. So these are all the signs and symptoms of an anemic person. I have a mnemonic, that is AMPFT. From this you can easily remember all these signs and symptoms. Let's see. A for anorexia, I for impaired bone healing, M for murmurs, P for pallor and palpitations, F fatigue and faintness, and T tiredness. So here we have the signs and symptoms of anemic person. And we have seen what is anemia is basically reduction in the concentration of hemoglobin. And we have also seen the typical values and WHO values of an anemia. Now let's move to the classification of anemia. So here we have the classification of anemia. We can classify anemia on the basis of two categories, on the basis of causes and on the basis of morphology. On the basis of causes, the anemia occurs due to blood loss, low RBCs production or high RBCs destruction. So these are the causes of anemia. On the basis of morphology, we have three main subcategories of anemia. These are microcytic anemia, second normocytic anemia, the third macrocytic anemia. Now let's see what does it means. Microcytic means all the absolute values are reduced, means MCV, MCH and MCHC, these absolute values are reduced. Normocytic means all the absolute values are within normal range, and the macrocytic, it means MCV, that is basically mean corpuscular volume, is increased and the macrocytes in the blood film are formed. So here we have the classification of anemia. Now let's move to the what are the tests in the laboratory are performed for the diagnosis of an anemic person. So here we have some diagnostic tests that are routinely performed in the laboratory for the diagnosis of anemia. First we have hemoglobin estimation. Second we have PCV determination. Third we have RBCs count. Next we have absolute values. Next reticulocyte count. And the last is blood film examination. So what are the absolute values? These absolute values are MCV or mean corpuscular volume. That is basically the average volume of the red blood cells. Next we have MCH or mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration, or amount of the, that is basically means amount of hemoglobin present in the red blood cells. The next is the MCHC or mean cell hemoglobin concentration. That is basically the average concentration of hemoglobin inside a single red blood cell. So that are all the absolute values. And here are all the diagnostic tests that are routinely performed. If your books are giving you hard time, so you can join our channel. Please don't forget to subscribe and share. For my untidy handwritten notes, you can follow me on Instagram. Thank you and take care.